Welcome back, everyone, to Small Tuber News. I'm your host, Gator the Legend, and I'm here to get you caught up on all the news and drama involving your favorite small tubers. Our first story today comes from Rising Small Tuber, That Strange Channel, currently sitting at 58 subscribers. Just the other day, That Strange Channel tweeted me some horrifically tragic news. At Gator the Legend, I got some news for ya. My only computer stopped working, so now I can't make videos until I get a new one, so I'm stuck live streaming through my PS4 on my second channel. Oof.
No, I can't accept this. Come on, world. Why do you do this to my favorite channels? Oh, God. Fate is a fucking bitch sometimes.
Hang in there, That Strange Channel. Don't you dare give up on your channels. You are never allowed to quit. YouTube without That Strange Channel is not a YouTube I ever want to be part of. You quit when I quit. Our next story starts with up-and-coming small tuber Michael Fayer Jr., currently sitting over 550 subscribers. I was recently invited on Michael's fan-favorite live-streaming series, Up and Coming Tubers, to discuss the origins of yours truly, Gator the Legend himself, and how my channel has become what it is today. I had an amazing time and was so grateful to have the opportunity to go and be part of his stream. A short time passed, and while talking to Michael on Twitter, I mentioned that I lived in Ohio. Coincidentally enough, Michael already had plans to meet up in Ohio with Rising Small Tuber, Yankee Outdoor Adventures, who was closing in on 2,000 subscribers. After that, his plan was to drive down to Southern Ohio, only 1 hour from where the Gator lives, and meet up with up-and-coming small tuber, The J-Men Show, who has 1,093 subscribers. And since I am only a hop, a skip, and a jump away from where they were going to meet up, Michael invited me to join them. We met up this past Thursday and went live on Michael's channel for his live series, Best Hour of My Day, and it lived up to its name and more. I have been YouTubing since January in 2015, and I have always wanted an opportunity to meet up with fellow YouTubers and to collaborate together. And it was everything I hoped it would be. Michael and the whole J-Men Show crew were amazing, very nice and humble people, and entertaining as hell. I want to thank the J-Men Show for coming out and collabing with me, and I want to send the biggest thank you I can to Michael. You not only set this whole thing up, but you drove all the way out to us. You helped me scratch off one of the things at the top of the list of things I've always wanted to do on YouTube. I had so much fun, and I cannot wait until the next time I get a chance to do this.
Back, everybody. Gator the Legend here with you as always, and you know, we're going on an adventure today.
Our next story comes from a new rising small tuber live streamer, Herman the Great, who has just hit 1,500 subscribers. Herman the Great, aka Herman the Legend, I am so happy for you. Trust me, I remember the day I hit 1,500 subscribers and the feeling was sensational. Even though no one in the real world cared, it did not stop me from telling everyone about this accomplishment. Herman the Great, congratulations on hitting this tier. Keep doing what you're doing, and before you know it, you'll be crossing 2,000 subscribers. Our last story of the day comes from up-and-coming small tubers Pusa Studios, currently over 1,800 subscribers. Just the other day, while checking my Twitter, I received a DM from Pusa Studios explaining that someone had flagged one of their live streams and that they were now banned from live streaming for 90 days. I could not have been more shocked and surprised. I've watched many Pusa Studios live streams and I have seen nothing but a couple down-to-earth people doing what they love with respect, honor, and dignity. I trusted and knew that there was no way this should have happened. My first thought was I'll do a small tuber news segment on this. But I knew that wouldn't change anything, so I decided to reach out to YouTube on Twitter, at Team YouTube, and attempt to get some help. After not receiving a response, I began posting to some big YouTubers that have responded to me in the past that I was hoping would help. I posted to Casey Neistat, Boogie2988, Keemstar from Drama Alert, and I even posted to Ricky Berwick, who responds to everyone. Alas, I received no responses, not even from Susan Wojcicki, the CEO of YouTube. I then noticed that my comment to YouTube had gained some traction. People were retweeting it and liking it, making their own responses to @TeamYouTube. My tweet read, "A channel named Pusa Studios has been falsely banned from live streaming. Please help them. They have already appealed. I just want to make sure small channels are getting fair and equal treatment. This should not have happened. Please help." I went to bed that night not knowing if anything I had done helped at all. When I woke up the next morning, I went straight to the Twitter to see if there was any update. I immediately noticed I had a DM from Pusa Studios saying that the suspension had been overturned. I could not have been more excited to see our small YouTuber community joining together and uniting as one to help one of our own during their time of need was overwhelming. I have always wanted us to find a way to join forces and to become the many. For far too long, we have all been on our own. And finally, we now have a community of support and love. I don't know if anything we did actually led to them overturning the suspension, but it doesn't matter, because on that day we made a statement. We showed YouTube that we won't back down, that we won't sit back and be taken advantage of, that we can make a difference. Pusa Studios, congratulations on getting your streaming privileges back, and keep doing what you're doing. YouTube has given us the ability and opportunity to do what we do, but that doesn't mean that we shouldn't fight to make it better, that we shouldn't push back when they take away from us. Life has always been about bettering yourself and your fellow people. YouTube is no exception. Fight when you must and be grateful when you can. I hate YouTube, but I also love it more than anyone will ever understand. Don't forget to stay until the end of the show for this week's featured SmallTuber music creator. This week's music creator is rising SmallTuber Faith in the Fallen and her original song, My Reach. Go and check out Faith in the Fallen and all the other small YouTubers I've mentioned in today's show and show them some support. Tell them the Gator sent ya. And if you want a story to be featured on SmallTuber News, hit me up. Either in the comments below, on Twitter, @GatorTheLegend, or @SmallTuberNews. Or send me an email to GatorTheLegend@Yahoo.com. And you just may be mentioned on SmallTuber News. And if you never want to miss an episode, make sure to subscribe with notifications on. Because if you don't hit the bell, it's like you're not even subscribed at all. Thank you guys so much for joining me today. And until next time, I've been Gator the Legend, and this has been SmallTuber News.
The night is calling, the day is over now. Don't cry no longer, 'cause you'll get stronger. I cannot reach what I can't find, so don't you hide from me. I'll seek throughout your wanders. I will be right by your side.